Life.
What's a moment in your life where your ops caught you slipping? Man? What happened?
Shit. I'm gonna call me slipping. You know what's so crazy? A nigga caught me slipping, but it was the shit that really brought me here to y'all. Like, it was like, this shit became a blessing in disguise. Like, I was out in the hood back where I was from, and goddamn, little nigga, I ain't never even seen him before. I'm just sitting out there, I'm talking to these other niggas trying to squash some shit between some of my niggas and some other niggas I knew. Like, I'm out there in the hood just mingling shit. I got my gun on my hip. Like, it's like, I got a 50 clip, it's a 40. I'm sitting there talking to cuz or whatever. And little dude ran from behind the corner, snatched that bitch on my hip, and goddamn, he tried to damn shoot me with that shit, but just goddamn luckily, I ain't had one in the head, and when he tried to cock it back, like, a lot of people didn't know my spring was fucked up on my gun. It was a 50 clip, but if you ain't had a whole 50 in that bitch, like, it was just one going low. Like, you had to stick that bitch on your hip and pull it in order for it to load. And I had just gave goddamn my girl at the time, her sister's nigga, like, 9 to fill up his gun, because he had the same type of gun, and he had, like, 3 bullets. And I'm like, nigga, you ain't coming nowhere with me without your clip, fool, you feel me? And I got 50 in mine, so I can give you a couple of bullets, you feel me? And then we had shot a few all there the other day, so I had literally, like, maybe like
30.
No, I probably had like 9 in that motherfucker. Like, we had literally been shooting and shit. We were drunk, you feel me? So, like, I'm talking about literally, like, and like, that shit be playing my head every day. Like, I swear to God, nigga grabbed that bitch off my hip, brushed that, like, he came up like this, he clicked it, then he realized it wasn't one in the head. He did like this, he kept trying to pull it. That's when he realized the bitch was jamming, and he realized he had to put the bitch on his hip, and then she just locked on his ass. And he, when he realized that, he got down, took off running. But like I said, this shit opened my eyes up, because if I was one of them niggas who just kept one in my head, that nigga would have shot my
gun. He took out running with the whole gun.
Yeah, he took out running with the gun. Like, but I'm gonna be honest with you, like, shit, fuck that shit. Like, this is a small sacrifice. Look, if me losing that gun is what bought me right here, fuck that gun. That nigga had 3 of them guns, nigga.
So after that, he had 3 of them. After that, you left.
Sure, like, nah, I'm about to say I slid or whatever. I slid down to a hotel at night, because I never had to regroup because of a lot of shit. Like, after that happened, I got into some other shit. It was just a lot of shit that night. But I ended up sliding to a hotel. Me and my brother, we got low and shit. We made a game plan because we slid out the city and shit. And we was like, yo, how the fuck we gonna handle all that shit? That ultimately led to, like, because we stayed at that hotel for like a week. We did and dabbed out the city trying to scope shit or whatever. You know, I can't really go into too much about that. But ultimately, at the end of the day, the ultimate decision, by that Thursday, we was on the way to Atlanta. But all that shit came from that situation. Me being here right now with you came from that situation.
So, man, that's crazy.
Because I was like, yo, that nigga could have really smoked my dumb ass. Like, if I was a reckless nigga like that, could have smoked my ass. And then it would have been like, damn, I did all that rap and all that bitch for no reason, just to die.
If the gun was fixed, nigga, you could have died.
Facts.